say, wherever I go, I used to say that forensic science is an omnipresent science. That is why I used to mention it is a numero, you know, and omnipresent science. You can see forensic science, the presence of forensic science everywhere, irrespective of the particular field. It is actually believed to be associated with the criminal investigation. Of course, I think it has become more popular thanks to crime scene investigation, CAD, all those serials which are being telecast in a number of channels. Probably Daya has become very popular because of this. And of course, apart from that, time since immemorial, I should say more importantly, almost 150 years ago, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, who has portrayed a very, very fictitious character, Sherlock Holmes. I think the Sherlock Holmes, whatever the technique he used for the investigation, even now we are following. You can imagine to what extent the brilliance of intelligence in Arthur Conan Doyle, how he portrayed Sherlock Holmes and Watson. So from then onwards, it has become very, very popular because of the main reason. It is the only science, scientific method wherein there is no scope of any escape or duplicacy or sort of a tampering or sort of manipulation. Nothing is possible with forensic sciences as far as the criminal investigation and identification is concerned. So those days it has been all through, I should say, till the 20th century, end of the 20th century, it has been believed that it is associated with the criminal identification alone. But it is not so. Of late, it has become very popular that each and every unusual thing that is happening in the day-to-day life is resolved on the basis of forensic sciences. Just to mention the particular irregularity, particular abnormalcy, particular unhappening, unnatural happenings, non-uniform, whatever deviates from normal, whatever deviates from a routine, that will be easily established based on the forensic science knowledge. So there is no such limit or boundary as such. We don't have any limits for forensic science. Everywhere it is present. Name the specialty that is there. There will be medicine, engineering, pharmacy, dentistry, veterinary, agriculture, accounting, whatnot. Everywhere it is present. So I will brief you one more thing. Because of the main reason it is subjudice, it is so sensational. You just switch on the television, any television channel, you just switch on, what are you coming across? Immediately, it is the entire news channel is totally hijacked by, I should say, it is totally filled with the sensation of Sushant Singh Rajput. So what happened? What happened to him? So actually, I put his slide in the very beginning, but I was feeling, instead of, because it is subjudice, things are going on. So I didn't want to take his name because already the investigation is on. So that is why I have mentioned, apart from that, there are a number of other people. There will be Sri Devi, a sudden end of her life. So like Sushant Singh, there was an unnatural death. Suddenly, her life ended. It was so mystic. It was such a mystery. That is, this a boy who was really found dead in the washroom. These people, I should say, very famous personalities like Narayana Tiwari. He was an Andhra Pradesh governor, very popular minister in Indira Gandhi's cabinet. And one more, he was implicated in allegations of biological fatherhood. He denied the fatherhood of his son, biological son, Shekhar Sharma. So everywhere there is a sort of a, what I can say, non-conformation. So that all can be confirmed through the methodical approaches with forensic sciences. So I can mention about this guy, Shiny Ahuja, who denied that it was an allegation against him by his own servant name. But later on, it was proved that it belongs to his biological things belonging to him only. Then he had to confess, yeah, I only committed the crime. So in that way, it needs to be understood the scientific approaches will be superior forever. So there is no denial about it. This man, everybody knows about, very, very, very popular. He was a minister also, Union Minister Shashi Tharoor. He was also implicated in the sense his wife ended her life in a mysterious circumstances. So it was found to be the case of toxin, where I have mentioned previously was the DNA. Here it is a chemical, toxic chemical. This man, who was a righteous minister, of course, he is serving the jail term now due to his misgivings. So in that way, it is possible to understand there are differences in the fields. The first two I was mentioning about chemistry, biology, chemistry here, accounting. This is the air crash that you nobody will be able to forget the air crash that recently happened in Kozhikode. And before that, almost 10 years ago, there was an air crash in Mangalore. So air crashes are not very uncommon, especially in the Southeast Asia and the subcontinent. So here, the most recent one in the neighborhood is, of course, Pakistan airplane, which got crashed 3 months ago. And now, almost 2 years ago, there was a plane crash in Kathmandu. These are the ones which will mention, give the detail about the particular supremacy of the scientific approaches. This is another sensational case, that is Sheena Bora murder. So here again, I can say it was a case of, it is more of a elegance, brilliance of the specific field called anthropology. So based on the anthropological data, in the sense findings, they could identify Sheena Bora's skeleton. It was belonging to Sheena Bora. Of course, day before yesterday also, I think even now it is going on. You would have noticed yesterday, every year it happens. Is it audible? Okay. Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there was a 5-story building. Day before yesterday, it collapsed. Almost 16 people were they lost their lives, and almost more than 30 people have been extricated from the rebels. Okay, fine. So a classical one. Almost an year ago, there was an Elephantine bridge collapse. It happened. There was a stampede that occurred, and the entire bridge, which was a monumental bridge in the Chhatrapati Shivaji terminus, which got crashed, in which almost 37 people have lost their lives. There's nothing new, but it is a case of an engineering malfunction, I can say, that I will be telling you in the future slides. This is a Mantralaya. This is the Secretariat of Maharashtra. So there was a sudden fire that occurred in the odd hours. In the odd hours, generally the journalistic term, I can say the hours, that was early morning, 2 o'clock, it was in fire. Only a particular building, particular room, particular cabins were set on fire. In the sense, I can't use the word set on fire, but I can say that it was, gutter. Because actually there were some evidentiary clues that they get the important files of some particular scam, other scam. So it was set on fire. So all these things, whatever happened unusually, that we will be able to find out based on the techniques, scientific approaches, what we call it as a forensic sciences. In fact, this needs to be understood. The everything, whatever we feel that it is unusual, naturally we are feeling that suddenly it has happened, it is a mystery. So I cannot say, for that matter, generally I used to take the case of RFE murder case, generally, which was actually most of the cases which I have dealt with only I used to refer. So this particular case we only dealt with. Today it was not possible that the entire, I mean, most of you would have seen the movie also. It was not possible that four inmates were there in a house that was totally locked. The house was locked from inside, and only two people have been killed and two were alive. So it's not possible to say that you people are, I mean, generally youngsters like to view, I mean, see the movies, horror movies, like evil spirits. They are very fond of the evil movies based on evil spirits. So it is not that evil spirit, it is a evil spirit. By the terminology itself, we can understand evil spirit. So there is nothing, there is no objectivity, there is no objectivism. So it is not that easy to have a scientific reasoning to bring up a fact that two people have been killed, there was a baby entered into the house and they killed. So there is no other chance except that two people who were alive have only killed the other two. That's all. So irrespective of the particular scientific evidences which are supposed to be, I mean, which have been allegedly tampered, I mean, in the sense, I should not use the word tampered, which has been, which is among the pitfalls, it is not possible to say that those two people have not killed them. But still, we are finding out the fact about linking this particular crime scene victim and the assailants in one or the other way, so that we will be able to prove the case, these two people only killed the other two people. Hope you understand, though I am not saying any particular name of the victim and the name of the criminal. So you people will be able to understand. So what went wrong can be established with all these things. So here I will move on to the four areas. So if at all I have been mentioning about things are happening everywhere, unusual things are happening everywhere.
Very sorry to interrupt you. Could you present the presentation once more?
Yeah. Is it visible now? Is it visible, Indu?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay, fine. I have been telling you there is no boundary, there are no limits. As such, it is boundaryless. So naturally, there is a particular feeling in you. So that means everybody is a forensic expert. You mean to say? I can see. Unless otherwise you have a specific attitude, specific approach, orientation and inclination, analytical skill with a particular field, you will not be able to call this up. So having said that, in any particular, what I can say, specialty, there needs to be a particular area exclusively meant for that. So in this condition, though I have told you everywhere there is a scope of forensic approaches, but still there is an exclusive aspect, there's an exclusive area is also there. Those are fingerprints, question documents, and ballistics, we call it as. Fingerprint, obviously, you know, as soon as anybody says about forensic science, anybody will be immediately thinking about fingerprints.
Babu sir, sorry to interrupt you, sir. Can you just maximize your screen?
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
So in that case, it is possible to mention that fingerprints are the particular core area with which it is an exclusive domain of forensic sciences. So in that case, it is not useful for anything else except for the identification. That means it is only meant for identification. Obviously, so when you are going for the bank, when you are going to open your account, when you are going for an insurance claim, when you are applying for an Aadhaar, when you are applying for a passport, anything, there is a requirement of the fingerprint. So Aadhaar is the ultimate one. That is, it will have your fingerprints. For that matter, it will have an entire profile through your fingerprint. So it is an identity. So your basic biometric is a fingerprint, which is exclusively meant for your identification. So absolute identification can be established only with fingerprints. So questioned identity can be resolved based on fingerprints. That is why it is being kept under forensic sciences. Next one is a question to documents where they mention about, so any particular document, I need to say bank, insurance, or everywhere, wherever you are going to submit your representation, you are going to represent yourself, that has to be in the form of a particular letter which needs to be signed by you. So that means the authenticity will be available only with the signature. So obviously the signature is your representative. You are being represented by a signature. So that means the authenticity of your identity in the paper, in the document, will be very much valid with your signature. So naturally, when it is under question, it needs to be analyzed. What we call it as is a question documents. For that matter, it is not related only with the signature analysis or handwriting analysis. For that matter, even assessment of bills, validity of the bills, validity of any document for that matter, even for that matter, I can include currency notes, passports. I think 2 days ago, you would have seen in the newspaper, there are as many as 2 crore valid bulk currency notes, at least, which were found to be fake, right? Not only that, that was a mark sheet scam, degree scam. Degree certificate scam was there. I don't want to mention about the particular state, but there were, I mean, not one state, there were 2 states involved. So there they were getting some degrees, bogus degrees with the same thing. But it was authentically, it was assessed based on the analysis on through question document examination. So this is the core, these three are the core areas. But having said that, it is all, developed in the 19th century, a fag end of the 19th century, and every part of 20th century. But when it comes to slowly in the coming, in the subsequent years, in the fag end of the 20th century, there was an inclusion of toxicology, which is exclusively meant for human consumption. I mean, whatever is being consumed by the human being, whether it is going to be a toxic one, that will be assessed in the toxicology. Probably it is in the form of, I can say, chronic toxicity, or in, as a clinical perspective, or in the acute toxicity in the postmortem perspective. So naturally, there are analysis that can be done in the particular chemical that has been ingested. For that matter, that is why I have given you the example of Sunanda Mishra. So in that way, there are DNA analysis. Of course, there are plenty of things we will be able to get to know for that. Let anybody, as I was mentioning, Chinese Gujarat, anybody. So in fact, not only the paternity, even maternity also. One such case I have come across, one child was claimed by 2 mothers. Of course, it happened 30 years ago when I was a student. That time we had to depend on only the serological examination. That is the reason why I am mentioning it as a evolved subject. That time, based on the serological examination alone, we were mentioning about the paternity and maternity testing. That is the blood grouping, RH factor, MNSS, all those things we were doing. And of late, that it has been overcome by the DNA analysis, wherein we are coming to know more and more authentically. That is a gold standard in the identification with an invasive procedure that is involving the biological fluids. Next one is voice. This is also another one important biometry, wherein I think Kassab. When Kassab was being, I mean, he went on a shooting spree in Mumbai, CST, he went to Taj. So they almost 160 people, they have kept on firing us, and those people have died the last year. Like, so ultimately we could catch only Hemant Karkare Saab. I think he credit goes to him, though he lost his life. But they could catch this boy alive, who was hardly 19 years old. That boy was trying to manipulate himself. This is the reason why I always used to say, you cannot manipulate science. You cannot manipulate the scientific evidences. It is more authentic, individualistic. So there is no possibility of tampering that. So voice analysis, that means he tried to behave or as if he was pretending to be a Punjabi, Hindu Punjabi. So it is not possible that the particular guy, though he tries to speak in Urdu, he tried to spell as if he is an Indian Urdu speaking guy. But ultimately, it is easy to establish the particular, for that matter, different states have got some sort of specific accent will be there. A dialect will be there. That will be very classical to the particular area. Even in Gujarat, we have Kathiawadi. We used to say Kathiawadi, South Gujarat. Other Gujarati speaking, but there is a contrasting difference you will be able to notice between the Kathiawadi and the South Gujarat, Surat people. So people speaking Gujarati in Surat, there is a difference. So also in cases of North Gujarat also. So everywhere it happens. So that is a classical one we will be able to establish based on the voice analysis. Of course, most important thing nowadays, everybody is fascinated towards the cyber forensics. Though you may try to fool your teacher or anybody that, sir, I was there, that and such thing. That is not possible because everything has been recorded. You are thinking that you have deleted your messages from your WhatsApp, but it has already reached, it is in the cloud. So it can be at any point of time, we can retrieve from the clouds. So out of all cyber forensics, forensic psychology, it is almost an investigative parameter because of the main reason I can say each and every such abnormality which is being deliberately being carried out, that we have huge volume of data is available in the CNS. I used to always correlate this thing. It is a synonym of CP, the central processing unit. How much it is important in a system, in the same way, here we have in the central nervous system. So here everything is stored. We will be able to retrieve the data from there. We can find the entire range of things, whatever has been done by the particular individual at any point of time, knowing, consciously. So naturally, a particular person who is committing a particular crime, he is doing it consciously. That means he is remembering that guy's name, who he has attacked, that guy's whereabouts, the usage of a particular weapon, everything is recorded. So it is not possible, though he may try to tell a lie, but it may not be possible that he will be able to suppress his vital parameters, blood pressure. He cannot have a control. Heart rate, pulse rate, breathing. So gathering skin response, everything will be possibly, out of all, there is a electroencephalographic graphic recording will be there in each and every neuronal activity that will be immediately recorded. So there is no scope of duping or failing lie or deception. Nothing is possible. So that can be done only with the intervention. That is, I think, though I can call it as a one availability is an invasive psychology, psychological investigation, non-invasive psychological investigation. Invasive method, of course, it is always implicated with a legal complications. That is, it needs to be, your permission has to be taken from the quota plant. In addition to that, the individual himself has to give a consent. Otherwise, it is not possible. But having said that, of late, as I told you, it is a slow, gradual evolution that has occurred. Like one of the most recent ones are the forensic engineering, wherein whatever I have told you previously, like a building collapse, a house collapse, any structural collapses, an industrial failure, a fire accident, a road traffic accident, anything whatsoever is related to a particular mechanical failure, we will be able to assess based on the forensic engineering concepts. So what went wrong in a particular building collapse, that we will be able to establish. Probably the particular fire would have occurred with a, I have to mention about there was a fire accident that took place recently in Vijayawada. Of course, COVID-19 hospital it was. There was a fire. Just before that, there was a another chemical tragedy that occurred in Visakhapatnam. So, and of course, continuously, one other, of course, I don't want to miss out our Ahmedabad hospital also, where there was a fire accident that took place less than a month ago. So, even the COVID hospitals, what went wrong, how we have identified, established, just based on the forensic engineering concepts that may be related to electrical, civil, and material sciences concepts. So, what went wrong can be established based on the forensic engineering, wherein we are applying the concepts of engineering specialties like electrical engineering, civil engineering, or material science engineering. This is one way it is possible, like we will be able to say that due to the abnormality, but exactly it needs to be found whether the particular system has gone wrong because of the machinery failures. That needs to be understood based on the material collection, evidence collection, properly analyzed, and it needs to be established is exactly whether it was a deliberate attempt or not. Because some of the cases which I have come across for the past 2 months, I had almost 3 such cases I have done. Most of them, all the 3 were like a deliberate attempt of fire in a vehicle. One is a vehicle, another one is an industry, cotton industry, and one a cotton mill. Another one was a textile industry. So here, everything was because of their ulterior motive of getting a compensation. So we could get to know about the details of this particular thing based on the concepts of forensic engineering only. Of course, most recent one is forensic odontology, wherein obviously the particular dental science, how it is being perceived to be only the clinical approaches. But of late, it is not so. There is a concept of, more important concepts of forensic sciences is always involved in that. That is mainly for the purpose of age estimation, gender, not only in the dead, even in the living also, there is a possibility of these things. That is, there may be chances of misrepresentation of their ages. That will be exactly established based on the dental examination. Of course, for that matter, it is not only related to that. And most important thing is disaster victim identification also. Though the particular individual has perished, the individual have died of extraordinary high temperature, extremely low temperature, whatsoever it is, irrespective of the temperature, because it is so resilient and robust, the dental tissues are possibly able to withheld to withhold the higher temperature. Thereupon, it will become a valid evidence for the purpose of absolute identification. And of course, nursing is available, wherein the approaches of the particular concept, what I can say, I'll be mentioning about any disaster victim identification. Then I will be able to mention about the any cases relating to women and children abuses, elderly abuses, of course, offenses against women, domestic violence, all sorts of things. There is a mechanism that the taking care of legal approaches as well as social and clinical approaches are being handled by forensic nursing staff will be possible. Next one is a forensic accounting. That is, I remember I was mentioning about Vijay Malia or Lalu Prasad Yadav and of course Harshad Mehta. Vast number of people, such people who have all been involved in such cases, that is money laundering cases, fraud lenses, they have all been investigated. Of course, the last two I have mentioned about Vijay Malia's case, some of my students have only done it, established how the fraudulence has happened. Not only this Satyam, case of a Satyam case, and one more is Choksi, Nirav Modi and Choksi. So these people, of course, they are out. But the exact nature of fraudulences has been established by this specific specialty, that is forensic accounting. Here, it is not that a particular accounting, in the sense, generally people will be mentioning about the credit and the debit, how the income has gone, how the, of course, they are all will be tallying. But the thing is, exact nature of transaction, the original point of transaction, what are the different methods of transaction, those all occurred will be established by only the forensic accounting people. So for that matter, it is not only related to money laundering, all types of fraudulences. For that matter, I can give you a simple example that anybody, in a normal life, people, in the your middle class society also, what they do is they will be entitled for a particular transport allowance by the government. So what they do, either a DA or a transport, they will manipulate, in the sense, when they have gone by traveling by a train, second class, they will climb for a upper class. So operator, things are very, 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 very streamlined that nobody will be able to climb. In fact, when I was entitled for a airfare, from then, almost 15 years ago, when I traveled by train, that time there was, we used to show only the particular tickets. How we generate, those days we were not getting the tickets online. We used to purchase from the counter in the offices of the particular airline. So we used to get the ticket. Nowadays, it is not so. So anybody can just get the flight tickets, online booking can be done. Whereas, unless otherwise the particular person has traveled, he will not be holding his gate pass. So naturally, the particular pass will be available only when the particular individual has traveled. So it is mandatory now they have to produce. Otherwise, they cannot go for a claims at all. So it is the simplest possible method that fraudulence can happen. So in that way, not only this number of other things, that is just inflating, that is instead of mentioning about not only the inflating in the form of a cost, even some people, they will be inflating the quality. That is, I don't want to mention about exactly the particular scandal that has occurred. One of the states in India, the government has purchased coal from Australia, mentioning that that coal is a very good standard. There it was found the cost was higher. Instead, the same coal could have been purchased from Indonesia. Chemically tested, then it was found they were equal in quality. Only thing is the transport, that is from Australia to here, that they will would have been able to make the bills inflated. So they have even, you won't believe that even in every such cases, forensic accounting, they have a highest position also. Even at a general manager level, there is a one particular person is being appointed. You can understand now, when people are coming and approaching me for the purpose of investigating for a false case, even a couple of weeks ago, I had to give an opinion on a particular claim from HDFC and United India Insurance for the false claims. So it is everywhere because of the lack of staff, lack of specialists over there. Nowadays, people are looking for exclusively a forensic accountant who has to be there for the purpose of establishing the right way of investigation. So that much of a vast potential and opportunities are available. As I mentioned, it is not contained only with the medicine engineering. Even pharmacy drugs are also authenticated based on their qualities. And wildlife, of course, you will be knowing that economically it is very, very high stakes are there when it comes to wildlife. That is, lion poaching case was done, in Gir Forest 14 years ago. It is mainly for the purpose of trafficking, illegal trafficking of those bones and horns and other things, wildlife. So they were sold for higher rates. So poaching were happening. That also is being investigated. These are the things I was mentioning about. So everywhere, physical, chemical, biological, digital evidence, psychological evidences are required. Of course, this can be done by microscope. Yeah? Okay. So each and everything I mentioned about, so where are the importances are, where is the scope? That means just based on the physical methods, we'll be able to authenticate any particular ornaments, a valuable item. Let it be gemstone. Not only gemstone, it is even gold standard. Whether the gold is 24 karat, you must be knowing the percentages are being given just on the chemical analysis. They're portable. That is, Government of India, there is a very strong department, environment, forest. So there is a particular department which has given such a stern punishment to the particular a cold drink, that is a beverage, which has been banned for some time because of the entry poisons. There are the adulteration also, mustard oil adulteration. Dara was very, very popular in testing. And of course, petrol and diesel are also being adulterated. This all will be falling under the category of chemical analysis. So I can say everywhere is chemical, within you, around you. So there is nothing more beyond chemistry. So chemical analysis has to be there. So forensic chemistry finds a fulcrum in every cases. This is what I was telling you about this guy. Of course, Casa-based science and significant investigation is possible with the forensic medicine experts, pathologists, forensic pathologists also, where there will be possibility not only the injury of genuine nature, even instant infection or manipulation, that also can be possible to be established. Let me stop here, and I would like to have some questions from you. It will be more interesting for me if at all you are asking more number of questions with me. Can you please?
Of course, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for the presentation. Now, anyone has any question? Then they can put up in the chat box, and sir will be answering that question. Sir, there was one question that what is psychology investigative?
Yeah. As I was mentioning about, it is more important to know that there are two things. One is clinical approaches, another one is forensic approach. Clinical approach is mainly for the purpose that a particular guy has committed a particular crime, under the pretext, under the condition of psychological aberration, psychological disorders. That is, a simplest example I can quote is somnolencia, in some somnambulism, sleepwalking, in a simplest sense, sleepwalking. So he gets up in the midnight, goes around in the night, 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock, they are going around the streets, and somebody comes across, robbery or anything. He physically attacks him, and he kills him, in the sense that guy is dead. So that he comes and sleeps overnight. Then next day morning, he doesn't remember. So in such a case, it is not possible to be make him responsible for this particular act. Though it is a crime that has been committed by him, still he cannot be held responsible. This is one clinical approach. That means to say, a particular individual cannot be held responsible for his criminal act when it is being committed under the circumstances in which he is unable to understand the consequences or conscious activity of the particular crime. So he is not conscious to commit that particular crime. That means we call it as mens rea. There is no such planning in his mind that he was going around. He was not very much conscious at that time. Suddenly he commits the particular crime and he comes out and he doesn't remember whatever has happened. This is because of his particular psychological disorder. So he cannot be held responsible. This is one. Next one is psychological investigation is, as I was telling you, every individual, when he is committing a crime, naturally he is having the story of the entire thing, memory. In the memory, he will be having the name, his other features, whatever he is related to, out of vengeance he is doing. Then he collects the information at what time he comes to the particular place and which is the particular weapon he has to handle to kill him. All those things he is having in his mind. So it has to be extracted. So it is possibly extracted based on the psychological investigation. This is investigative psychology. There it is a criminal psychology. Okay. Hope I think you are clear now.
Yes, sir. So there is one next question. Can you explain about the voice analysis?
Yeah. Voice analysis, as I was mentioning about, there are two things. That is, one is a particular individual we are going to identify, a probable identification is being given. That means this particular guy belongs to Gujarat, Saurashtra, based on his accent and phonetics, whatsoever it is. But exact identity will be possible only when we are going with a parameter, what we call it as a frequency and amplitude. So when I say in Gujarati, Kemcho, when I say I'm giving a stress, Kemcho, so it is not, it is easy for anybody to understand that I am a non-Gujarati speaking. So it is really established. That is one thing. But exactly, you have to get the identity based on my inherent frequency, which nobody else can have. So individuality with me, the particular frequency will be only with me. That frequency cannot be imbibed or inherited by somebody else. This is what is a voice analysis. There we are focusing on two important things. One is a frequency, another one is an amplitude. Okay? Scientifically, scientific parameters.
So another question is, do we have to follow any procedure to undertake cases for forensic investigation?
Actually, I wanted to say, sorry to say that I am not very happy about that, but still, because of the evolution that has occurred, now, if at all I am switching on the TV, there are 2-3 people, they are speaking about Sushant Singh Rajput. They are nowhere in the picture in the investigation. But everybody has started doing the investigation. Those people are actually private investigators. Of course, there is no accountability for them. Whatever they say, it cannot be taken. But for the purpose of we people, the common public will get so fascinated about there. So everybody will have a feeling, private investigation is also there. Of course, this concept is widely seen in Western countries, not in India. Slowly, it is coming up in India also, that is private investigation. So those people are also doing. Of course, with due respect, I should say, they are not up to maintenance of the standard, but still they are trying to cope up with to a certain extent. How well they will be able to establish or solving the particular crimes. So you can very well switch on, even today you can switch on India Today, Times Now, or any channels, you can see somebody is speaking about the, I mean, investigation. Actually, they are not belonging to police or forensic science, but they are the private people who are investigating. There are, I mean, I don't want to mention about certain, I mean, major cities, there are such organizations who are doing this investigation. Yeah.
So there is another question. Does forensic play any role in dentistry?
Yeah, exactly. What I told you previously. Because in certain cases, we won't be able to get gold standard DNA. It's not available in a particular case because it has been destroyed totally. So in a very high temperature, charred, it is totally charred, but it is resilience. The resilience of heart tissue is always there that we will be able to get to know about the personal profiling of an individual that nobody can deny about. This is a more flourishing subject of late. It is more and more flourishing. Yeah. It is for identification. Yeah, any other? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other questions?
Sir, question is, will voice analysis just give an assumption or the exact and expected result?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. As I told you, CASAP, we have taken, I mean, it has been taken over a period of time, it has been taken, and the particular frequency and other things were matched to be sense that it is belonging to. Imagine a particular coke skull. There was a coke skull in the sense I have planted a bomb in a particular airplane. It is a coke skull. It has been recorded. It is found that it is casting as per the frequency and amplitude. And there are probably, there are some people the police has suspected. So those people have been brought and they have been asked to speak. Then it has been matched with and it is found so-and-so has only spoken. So it is authentic. There is no question about it. That is the reason why it is being called as a voice biometric. Yeah.
So another question is, according to the condition of India, which forensic master program is suitable for the future?
For that matter, I don't undermine any subject. I never undermine any subject. All are equally important. There is nothing like this is superior, this is inferior. Each and every subject has got its own versatility and opportunity, everything. So I cannot single out a particular subject. Whatever you take, just be, just give 200% into it. You will be successful. Yeah.
So last question is how to do DNA analysis?
Yeah, this is a very, it's a separate specialty. Of course, any particular body fluid, not necessary we need to be invasive, not necessary to go for a blood at all. It can be of any body fluid. We will be able to do it. Let it be, I mean, for that matter, even the hair follicles also. So any body fluids will be possible. Of late, even touch DNA has also been tried out with, but the limited success was there because the residual tissues which are available due to that touch is also mattering much. If it, I mean, definitely it matters more because of the reason the quantifiable data should be available over there. Otherwise, it will be successful for that matter. It is a gold standard, no doubt about it. We can do. It's a separate entity, a very good specialty, an attractive specialty.
Good. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay.
It was a